lay low, lay low, lay low.
Guys, Chris is running a little bit late tonight, so I'm going to do my best Chris impersonation for you. Got the wave down, green screened his backdrop. What else do I got? So we got it. He'll be here soon. He'll be here soon. Fake snickerdoodle. I'm not fake snickerdoodle. But what's up, guys? Welcome. I'm going to try to do this like Chris does. That look real? Hang on, I get it over to the chat. All right, welcome in. Yeah, brilliant backdrop, right? Like if you go and you, or Chris sends you a photo, you can use it as a green screen. Welcome in. I'm not gonna do it the way he does it because I don't do it as well. I told him, I said, let's just go, I'll take care of it. We got Corby Sinclair, Debbie Bernfeld, Janice, Disney, 1974, Kenneth H., Mara in Memphis. I'm not going fast enough. Main Street Nick, Happy's Haunt, Jeff Condon, Kenneth H., Corby Sinclair, Janice, Disney, 1974, Stacey Rogers, not going fast enough, Debbie Bernfeld, Nick D'Ambrosio, Modern Molly, hey sis, Jeff, let's see here, I got you. Still going, Steve, still going. Corby Sinclair, hello. Hello. It's still going. All these people chatting. Is that what he said? Samantha Lowe, hello. Man, my arm's tired. How does he do this? Wendy B. Hello, Wendy B. And got that person. Got that person. Oh, my gosh. It's still going. There's so many. Hang on. It just jumped on me. Oh, there it is. Came back. We got Team Marie's place. Is Dad Bill's waiting for Snickerdoodle? I don't know where he's at. He just said he's running a little bit late. We got Pete McDevitt's show. Hello, Pete McDevitt. Oh, man, my heart's getting tired. All right, I'm almost there, guys. I'm almost there. And there she is. The Daisy to his Donald. The Betty to his Barney. Not the Vision one. What's her name? The Wanda to his Vision. The Snicker to his Doodle. Hi, Angela Minta. Welcome in. Jennifer Caruso. Got to see Jennifer last night. Hello. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Oh, my arm's getting tired. Robert Dixon.
Play faster.
Faster? Faster. Robert Dixon. Julie McCowan. Oh, it's too tiring. I'm not even close to the bottom yet. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh.
That's all right.
Oh, I can't do it anymore. Hey, how'd you get here?
Hey, I'm here.
You want your chair back?
Sure.
I don't know how this works. You got more people to say hi to, Chris.
I got more people. Hi there, everybody.
Hey, Get this out of the way. Okay.
Okay.
Whoa!
Careful.
This one doesn't stop.
That one doesn't stop. Now I got to get into this one.
You get into that one.
Yeah. It's like human Jenga. Or Alma.
Wait.
That's a big foot.
All right.
Hey.
Yes, the Snicker to his Doodle.
Yes.
Yeah, that works.
Welcome in, everybody. Hey, hey. So...
Toodles!
Toodles!
Oh.
Yeah, no green screen. Hey, buddy.
Hi.
I feel like we should start over with our usual.
By the beauty of technology.
Yes.
I'm able to stream.
Live via satellite.
From my hotel room. With the outline of my person.
Here we go. So it's Tuesday.
Did anybody comment about the fish moving? When I said
I don't think
so.
I was too busy enjoying watching somebody else. This is weird.
I don't like your mouse.
I love this mouse.
Your mouse is weird.
It's not.
It's got a ball mouse. Is this real or fake?
It's real.
Well, that kind of hurts. So Steve, I would say it's real.
TV screen, do not leave a shadow on.
I didn't even make it to this. I didn't make it to all these comments about when I said hello. Oh, yeah. It would have been a great April Fool's joke.
It would have been.
I was going to hook up my laptop and then let Chris sit on it somewhere like he was in the hotel room.
Yeah. We had all different scenarios.
We changed our mind because
several times.
We were just hanging out.
Sorry we were late. I took Steve on a tour of the town.
Yeah.
So. Trackballs are the way to go. Yes.
No. Yeah. Right guy, what's up?
Hey, hey, bud. And Jeepa Joy says, welcome to the upstate SC, Steve.
It's as high upstate as you can get, pretty much. I mean, I would just cross the line from California. What's the other one? North Carolina.
North Carolina.
Yeah. Cross the line into South Carolina.
Hey, Jeff Condon. AI is getting really good. Yeah.
It's like we're almost here.
Mm-hmm. So, I think we're still going to do book club.
Stacy, there are no traffic lights in my hometown. There are a lot here. Mm-hmm. He's a bigger
It's a bigger town than what he's used to.
It's bigger than my small town.
Yeah,
there were several stoplights and grocery stores and stuff. More gas stations than I've got, you know.
Yeah.
Went to the local grocer and got me some sunflower seeds.
No sleepover. No, we're not having
no,
pillow
I got to drive back.
Yeah. No slumber parties, no pillow fights.
Well, There might be a pillow fight.
There are a bunch of pillows over there.
Oh, yeah, we couldn't have a pillow fight.
Yeah.
So this is where it's at.
Steve was impressed with the setup.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And he met the parents.
I did.
The first person from the community to meet the parents.
Yes. Mom and dad are nice.
Yeah.
Well, since your dad builds, though, is it grandma and grandpa builds?
I guess so.
Mom and pa. Mom and pa builds.
Meemaw and Poppy.
Meemaw and Poppy builds.
Yeah. Steve's World, bring back some Diet Sun Drop. We could have got that tonight, actually.
Was it there?
I got it. They had that.
So I went with two different things. I got a big thing of Promised Land chocolate milk.
He better not spill it on the computer.
You're going to spill on Chris's computer. And then I got a six pack of my zero sugar A&W root beer.
Yep. Thank you, Tina. There really aren't enough emotional support hippos for this model. See, I didn't even tell Tina.
And she said, she sounded like she would say it, emotiona. Emotiona. Emotiona support.
Emotiona support.
But no, it's ours. They don't pronounce it. That's right.
Yeah. He did. He got to meet the parents before you, Snickerdoodle.
Yes, I'm the real Snickerdoodle. Yeah.
Yeah. So.
And all the puzzles. I'm trying to figure out which ones I can take with me. There are like some over here, some over there. There's some back there, there's some over there.
He actually spotted two that he doesn't have.
I don't have.
I was shocked. I figured all the ones I had, he had. And they're probably already done.
Yeah, there's a lot here. Oh, there's more down here. What's
this? Oh, Steve, you'll be stopping at every gas station on the way home.
They haven't done that one yet either. It's still in storage. That one looked a little weird to do.
Yeah.
It's
me, David T. Welcome in. Howdy. Good to see you. Now we know the real reason for the visit. Puzzle snatching.
Chris is going to be reading. I'm just going to disappear for a minute.
Yeah.
I mean, look at this.
Yeah, there's the Lego.
I mean, we got Lego builds over here for like the was I not supposed to show that?
No, we worked on that last night. Yeah.
Well, that's I tried to join, but
yeah. Somebody didn't want you to, apparently.
Apparently Tina was blocking me.
Yep. So yeah, we'll blame it on Tina. That's what we'll do. This is Thelma Louise without the sad ending. Yeah. Mike 88, howdy, buddy. And Snickerdoodle, that was a pretty good intro for Steve to do. That was pretty good. I was impressed.
I did a good job.
The Scarlet Witch to my vision. I'll have to remember that one.
I did say Wanda. I didn't say Scarlet.
Did Wanda,
I should have
done
that one. But I mean, my favorite was the Snicker to your Doodle.
That was yeah. Backglue has all the new.
Although a snicker is a kind of a giggle and a laugh and a doodle. Well,
right.
We don't want to be laughing at any doodles.
You know what was the topic of discussion last night?
Lego?
When you couldn't join?
No.
The dangle of the angle.
The angle of the dangle.
Yeah, that one. Yeah.
Right, guy.
We discussed that last night. I thought my screen was messed up at first. No, sparkly pink.
Look at that one. At least.
Oh, look, it's the girl child.
Hi, girl child. I might know some K-pop stuff.
I've got a poster over there. I meant to show you. Yeah. Hey, sweetheart. That's my girl. That's the first time she has popped in the chat.
Oh, wait, put her back up there. What was that picture? Which one is that?
Yes, tell us which one that is, team.
Which band? Is that, what's the one that,
That's from 17, I bet.
17. What's the one that had their own Lego?
That's BTS.
BTS. I knew it had to be in it.
Let us know who that is, or I'll call you. Jeff Condon, no hippos, just a hello. Thank you,
sir. Oh, I'm waving off to the side. You can't see.
Yeah,
hi.
There you go. Thank you, sir.
Oh, these move.
Yeah, they move. You can drop those down.
They're supposed to move?
Yeah,
well, they move in like
it's
like the chair's hugging me.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I like it. Yep. It's a happy chair hug.
The girl child. All right, here's the girl child. No, not true. I've been here before. Oh,
he just never saw you.
I
ignored you.
This is DK from Seventh. I knew it was Seventh.
Got it.
Yep. That's Jeff's favorite group. Yep. Wow.
Cool.
Not even the Boy Child has popped into chat tonight.
So wow. Yeah. I did see the Boy Child earlier, though.
Yeah.
We chatted for a while.
Yep. So. So, yeah. I guess we should get to the book club, but. It's fun just
oh, look at the first sentence of it.
Someone was shaking her.
Because she woke up.
Because she woke up.
You got to recap.
All right. So recap last week. Here we go. I'm trying to remember how we started. Oh, we were walking through the woods. They were having a nice little walk, but starting to get a little tired. And Aurora... They came upon some trees, and Aurora saw this little glowing orb, and it came towards her, and there was a person in the little glowing orb, and then they blew up to almost human size, and it was a fairy, and then other ones started coming, and she couldn't believe how pretty she was, how pretty Aurora was, and they wanted to start making her pretty and start pampering her like a princess should be. And so they put up this partition, and they started doing Prince Philip's nails or something, and then they started doing her hair, and they took off the ratty dress off of her, and they put her in this new dress they made out of the trees or something, and then as she was they kept changing the dress over and over again. And telling her how pretty she was. No, don't do that. No. And then she started feeling uncomfortable because it started feeling like Maleficent would make her do, or her friend made her do with trying stuff on and telling her how pretty she was.
She's so pretty.
She didn't like that. Well, thank you. So then Aurora tried to escape, and she grabbed the prince. And they started to escape, and the fairies didn't want them to leave. And they told them that she should stay there and be pretty. And that'll make her more pretty. And then Aurora was like, no, we're leaving. And they tried to leave really fast. And then the fairies started turning into like demons. Exactly. And they started clawing at them and fighting them. One of them like dug into Prince Philip's head or something, and they fought and got away, and they found a house with a fence with symbols on it, and they dove over the fence, and the bad demons couldn't come in. And then they went and they had some gooseberry wine. I don't know that it was gooseberry, but I'm going to say it was. And then they danced. And they partied, and they had a good time, and then they decided they should stay there for the night, but they needed to get someone to move them somewhere the next day to get to the house, and they talked to a man that was there selling stuff, and he proposed a challenge that Aurora had to sing against, like, a cuckoo, a wooden bird or something, a metal
mechanical bird.
And so they were in this singing competition.
Oh.
Exactly. Just like American Idol. Mm-hmm. Then Aurora started like drooling blood. She was singing so high. Like that. And then the bad guy said that he won. And then come to find out the bad guy was a demon. And he got to come in because someone let him in. Mm-hmm. And then they killed him. And then
you shall not pass.
Exactly. And then Purple Subi, hello, welcome in. And then they fell asleep on a bale of hay, and then Aurora woke up.
And that's where we left off.
That was welcome to Dad Builds Theater.
Yes. With
Steve, the star performer. This is great TV, says Robert Dixon. It's not Dolby. It's what It's not Dolby. It's Stolby. Stolby.
Steve.
I get it. I like it.
Or because I stole the show.
You stole it. You did. Way to go. Yeah. So we pick up. Welcome in, Tony Fantasmic Chronicles. Good to see you.
Hola.
So we pick up then with to sleep, perchance to drink.
let me verify that.
That's when she finally woke up. She fell asleep. Fell asleep sleeping.
Not to sleep, perchance to drink. Okay, we're good.
Okay, we're good. All right, good.
Carry on.
So I think tonight I'm doing one chapter and then you do two.
No, you're doing this and then the other thing. Okay. After this is like three pages or something like that.
Okay.
Chris?
Here we go. Don't spill the chocolate milk.
I don't even know how. I didn't even do it, man. What? It's like, there's a hole in my chocolate milk. It's even on a coaster.
Wow.
What's going on here?
I can't even let you in the house. Next week, Steve tells the story recap and Chris's storytelling. Yes. We can mix it up.
It's on the puzzle bill.
David Bernfeld wants to know, is there some alcohol in that chocolate milk?
There's not. There's not.
No. Party foul.
Party foul. Listen, I just lost the... Is it called Once Upon a Dream?
Yes.
Parents were unfortunately lost. There it is. Got it. Okay. Good. All good. All good in the hood.
Is Steve drinking chocolate milk and eating funny gummies? No.
I'm eating sunflower seeds.
Sunflower seeds.
And, well, I don't know what this is. It's the Promised Land.
Promised Land.
Best I'm used to, milk. Like, my camera's on top of my monitor. So I keep holding stuff here, and it's over there.
It's over here. It's between the two monitors. So, yeah. If spiders end up here, I blame Steve's spilling. Yes.
It's all cleaned up. There is no evidence that I spilled anything. Mm-hmm. Except maybe this.
Yep. See?
Right there.
There it is.
That's just like, I could have blown my nose and that could be, does it smell like?
It smells like chocolate milk. I can't have it. Don't do that.
Chocolate milk.
Okay. Here we go. To sleep, perchance to dream.
I'm going to look over here.
Okay. Someone was shaking her. Aurora rolled over and saw concerned looking adults. Serious people in somber clothing and gold medal. Lions of office.
Medallions.
Okay, thank you. They crowded over her. Wake up, your highness. It's over. You're queen now. Maleficent has been overthrown. Your parents were unfortunately lost. We need you back at the castle. We can get you there. It's all a terrible mess. Aurora blinked and let herself be pulled up. They were very insistent and a little rough. She turned once to look at the prince, who should still have been sleeping, but it was like she couldn't see him. Philip, she croaked, her voice still hoarse from the contest. Later, the apparent leader said, we've a lot to take care of, milady. Excuse me, I mean, your majesty. I am the Castellan. I worked for your father, the king, and now you. She was shuffled to a waiting carriage, golden and royal, pulled by four beautiful chestnut horses. Before she could give them a friendly pet, the door was opened and she was ushered in, and they immediately set off. She bounced around and sleepy and sick, and in no time at all, they were out of the forest pulling up to the castle, which was neither covered in vines nor looked like it had ever been. This was how she knew she was finally awake. I still doubt this.
Yeah, it sounds fake.
Yeah. The moat was black and filled with water, and they crossed over the drawbridge and through a bailey uninterrupted by several gardens or rain catchers. It was crowded with normal life, peasants, tradesmen, merchants, farmers, and animals. You must speak to the people, the Castellan was saying. He held her arm as she stumbled out of the carriage, unable to tear her eyes away from the scene. Your parents would have wanted this. My parents, she blinked in the bright light, morning light, bright late morning light. Please, your majesty, there's no time to explain all of that later. he said. There are lines on the Castilian's face and single age spot near his serious straight brows. He wasn't a pretty person or an ugly person either. That was neither another reason she knew she was awake and that this wasn't a dream. They pushed her into the castle and up a flight of stairs. Someone hastily threw a purple velvet cape around her shoulders to cover up her rags. Someone else stuck a very golden and very heavy diadem on her head. Her neck bit under its weight. A scepter was placed in her right hand. Then she was shoved in front of a large window, the same window where she had last seen Maleficent ordering her capture. Horns sounded. The chaotic crowds below suddenly turned, almost as one, to look up at her. Aurora stood as tall and erect as she could, trying not to gape like a goldfish. She was still sleepy, and her mind was clouded, and the crown was heavy, and the cape was hot. There were strands of hair in her face that were very tickly. What should she say? What could she say to all of those expectant faces below? What had happened, really? She had fallen asleep, and then, Philip said, the fairies put everyone in the kingdom to sleep, and then they were ruled in the nightmare world by the undead Maleficent, and now they were free by means she didn't understand. But their king and queen were dead, her mother and father, whom she had never known in either world. Didn't she get a moment to mourn that? Good people, she tried to shout. It came out as an ugly, croaking whisper. You are now free. Everyone looked expectant. A few people clapped. Obviously, those who heard what she said knew that already. I am now your queen, she strained to say as loudly as she could. Your old king and queen, my parents, are gone, I guess. I am your new queen, and I will try to do that to the best of my abilities. Being queen, I mean, from now on. There was scattered, confused applause. The Castilian pulled a hand over his face. Men around him in important floppy hats looked similarly disappointed. Come, there are other things to be done, he said, trying to sound optimistic. Much has fallen behind because of recent events. She was whisked away from the balcony and pulled back downstairs. No one took the scepter, crown, or cape away. She wished they would. They spirited her into a private audience chamber, the one she had never entered when she lived with Maleficent. It was where the queen consulted with her closest advisors, where only the most serious claims were brought before her. Aurora was plopped down in the large throne-like chair at the end of the room. The wood was hard and uncomfortable under her. She wished she could bunch up the cape and use it as a cushion. This was also how she knew she was finally awake. Men and women of all stations loitered at one end of the room, looking impatient and angry. Another important-looking fellow immediately approached her. From his black velvet ensemble and pretty buttons that looked like coins, Aurora decided he was the treasurer. Your Majesty, he said, the emergency coffers are dangerously low. Should there be a blight this year, we have nothing left to rely on. A blight? Of what? He said impatiently. As there was a decade ago. Oh, of wheat.
You just missed one letter. It's all good.
A wheat blight, she said, still unsure of what that meant. Your Majesty, what shall we do? He pressed politely, if impatiently. What protocol does one normally follow in these cases? She asked, wondering if she had the right to feel proud about how well she had phrased the question. Didn't it sound regal? I recommend we raise taxes immediately, he said with a shrug. An emergency tax of an additional 5% mulcher, plus a gold plus a geld of 2.5. That should cover it. All right, she said slowly, let's do that. There were howls of fury and stomping. She jumped in her throne, shocked by the outburst. The treasurer rolled his eyes. What is wrong? They don't want to pay taxes, the Castellan explained from where he stood on the other side of the throne, with her in between and the angry crowd. They think running a kingdom is free. What's a tax? Aurora whispered. The Castellan gaped at her. Then he shook his head and turned away. She turned back to the treasurer. What's a tax? She repeated. Your Majesty, he said through gritted teeth. Now is not the time for a lesson in basic economics. Now is the time for swift, decisive leadership. We need a decision. Now. I can't without knowing what all this means, she protested. What kind of queen is she? A storm-faced, craggly old man with religious vestments spat. What is this we've been left with? Aurora looked desperately through the crowd, hoping for a friendly face. But all of these expressions ranged from hate to confusion to disappointment. She wanted to run. She just wanted to get out of the room as fast as possible and run as far as she could. Back to the village where they had found her. Back to the woods. Back to her old hiding places in the Dreamworld castle. She gripped the armrests of the throne to keep herself from leaping and fleeing. What do I do? She asked. The Castellan just shook his head again in disgust. What do I do? She asked again louder. What do I do? What do I do? She screamed. No one would answer.
Okay, before you go on. So the next one was not the short one. Okay. So we can do one of two things. You can either read that one, and then I would have the big long one to read. Or I can read this one, and we can just chat for the rest of the night. Your call.
Let's just read this one.
Okay.
And then we'll chat.
It's a different kind of night, you know?
Yeah.
Awakening, sort of. Yeah.
Sort of.
She's still asking, what do I do?
She's still asking, what do I do?
She doesn't know. No, somebody tell her. What do I do? What do I do? What do I do? What do I do? It just keeps saying, You can't say it. It just keeps saying, what do I do, over and over again. Philip was shaking her. She screamed hoarsely and constantly until her eyes finally registered the hay around her, the night outside, Philip's face lit by the stars. Rose, are you okay? Rose, it was just a nightmare. Then he paused, realizing how ironic and weird that sounded. She blinked for a moment, taking it all in. Then she began to weep. What's the matter, Rose? He put his arms around her and pressed her face to his shoulder. Now someone was finally holding her, but she was too overwrought to enjoy it properly. My gifts, she said, still coughing a little. The fairies gave me grace and beauty and song. That's what Maleficent was trying to trap me with, beauty and song. Yes, Philip said, a little confused. His deep brown eyes were even darker with concern. He picked a strand of hair out of her face and laid it back with the others. But we beat her. She didn't win. She won't win. No, Aurora, Rose said, trying to form the words clearly despite her shakiness and hoarseness. You don't get it. They gave me beauty and song, and then I was left in the woods to grow up for 16 years before being handed over to you. I don't know anything about ruling. I don't even really know what taxes are. I was in the woods in the real world. In the dream world, I hid like a mouse and then organized balls and parties. Giggle
a little bit.
your shoulders kind of went like that. So, oh, Philip said. Oh, he said again. Incredible writing right there.
Yeah, very.
Well, my sisters aren't exactly being taught how to lead an army into battle, but they're not an only child. She cried, instantly regretting it. Her throat burned. Even if Maleficent was right, even if my parents were hoping to have a male heir after me, they didn't. Shouldn't they have had some sort of plan B? Well, and I'll bet your sisters are taught something, she went on. I'll bet they know how to sew or organize the kitchen staff or, of course, Philip said without thinking. Bianca is known quite widely for her skill in embroidery, actually. And Bridget began to take over some hostess duties after my mother died. My dad said that she actually had some quite innovative ideas about how to peacefully handle the tolls on the northern trade route. Princess led out an incoherent, strangled cry of rage. "Sorry," he said quickly. "What are beauty and song good for? To a princess or a queen? It's not like I could join a wandering band of troubadours. These gifts have nothing to do with running a castle or a country, and everything to do with being a perfect, pretty wife for the prince I was engaged to marry when I was a baby." "Hey now," Philip said slowly. "We fell in love." I know. That's not the point," she said irritably, scratching her hands through her hair like a crazy person. She sort of remembered loving him, but it was strangely secondhand, mixed in with all the other memories that didn't quite feel real. Now she had no idea what she felt for him. She began to weep again, exhausting, racking sobs from a girl with two false childhoods and too many memories of no past. Grace and beauty and song and nothing more. And of course, despite the muddy tracks of tears down her cheeks, dusty with wheat chaff, and her tangled hair and her strange dress, she was beautiful. Philip hugged her and stroked her hair down. "Shh, try to get more sleep, or rest at least. We can't go anywhere until the sun comes up, so we might as well conserve our strength. I promise, no more nightmares." The princess didn't want to fall asleep again, but she did, and it was dreamless. The next morning, she was woken by something uncomfortably sharp cutting into her side. Irritably, she moved aside and saw that it was Philip's sword. Despite her resentment, she couldn't help admiring the delicately traced motifs winding their way up the grip from the pommel, the golden vines and decorated initials that carefully faceted in inset gems. She cautiously picked up the blade. It was lighter than she had expected, but heavier than she could easily manage. Even to her inexperienced hand, it felt extremely well balanced, though it would take force for her to swing it. She could manipulate the tip easily with just a turn of her wrist. She ran her left hand down its sharp... What do we read, dear?
I'm not sure.
A little stuffy there. She ran her left hand down its sharp edges, feeling metal that was kept clean and sharp and grew noticeably colder the longer she had it out in the hair. This is way harder to read when I can see you right here with your shoulders shaking. So there was a tiny recent nick in the left side. She put it down carefully next to Philip. She was stretched beyond her physical limits, murky-headed, exhausted, and weak. Apparently, you did need sleep in the dream world, even once you knew it was a dream. Philip slept harder than she, innocent of troubling thoughts and incoherent pasts. It was quite a while before his handsome features began to twitch and his spirit began to surface to the waking world. Aurora Rose watched him, contemplating his boyish face, which had just begun to lean out in the way of a man. Although her mind kept getting stuck on the concept of love at first sight, she could understand being struck by those looks. And already she was slowly being won over by his optimism and general wholesomeness. But to promise yourself forever to someone you had just met, life in the woods must have taken an even greater toll on her patience and mind than she had thought. Still, some pleasant dream pulled his lips into the tiniest smile. Aurora Rose leaned forward with some idea of trying a kiss, a small one, before he woke up, just to see. But suddenly he was moving, stretching and running a hand through his hair. The princess hastily sat backward. He didn't notice. "Morning. Boy, I haven't spent a night in the haystack in years," he said amiably. "You've done this before," she asked in surprise. The prince looked chagrined. "You sort of..." Okay. "You sort of chafe under the whole crown prince bit after a while. You sneak out for a good adventure with your best lads, hunting, hitting the taverns, waking up in an orchard with your head pounding and starving for that grouse you swore you were going to get. Don't look at me like that. I'm not the first prince to do so." She wasn't sure what look her face made. It was an amazing, rebellious idea. It's really hard to read with you here. She had never considered actually running away from anyone, even her aunts, except for the one night in the forest. Was your father angry? "Oh, you have no idea," Philip said with a rueful grin. "He took my sword and bow away and forbade the stables from releasing my horse, Samson, to me. And I had an extra chapter of Cicero every night for 2 weeks. Cicero! The man couldn't even end a sentence if there was a dagger in his throat. I mean, I guess there was eventually. But it was totally worth it, though. Not for me, Cicero." They got up, brushed away the worst clumps of dried grass and dirt, adjusted their clothes, and set off again. The village was starting to come fully alive in the morning dream sun. Can I, before I keep going, are we back in the dream world again?
Yes. Okay. So she was dreaming in the dream world.
She woke up.
But she woke up still in the dream world.
So, Inception, three layers.
Yes.
Okay. The woodsmen had left a long time ago, but the other men and women were tending to the, were tending their kitchen gardens, heading out to the fields, going to forage in the forest with baskets to fill with berries and mushrooms. The tink, tink, tink of the smithy cold foraging, something small echoed across the flat ground. The animals grazed or wandered and dozed or chewed contently. A couple of old palfreys hung around a tree, heads together like a pair of gossips. "We could steal a horse," Aurora Rose said slowly. "That would be faster than walking." "No," Philip said immediately. "No, we couldn't. But it's just a dream. Who cares?" Even as she said it, she wasn't sure if she believed that statement herself. "So we could just steal and kill and rape and plunder, and it doesn't matter," Philip said, as if it was something he had already deliberated in his own head. "I don't believe that. We're still the people we were when we were awake. It's not always the result of the decision that's important. It's how we make those decisions. It's the sort of people we are." "Oh, I'm not making any sense." "Yes, you are. I wouldn't know how else to put it. There's more to it for me, though. I've lived two lives, and each seems equally real and equally imaginary. I was telling myself before we met this time that all I have is my own eyes and hands to tell me what's real. Who knows how long I'll be living in this version of my life? It seems real to me. So I'll act like it is, whether it's fairies or castles or evil queens or thorns." She stopped, thinking about the thorns. How they disappeared under her touch. "Yes, what is it? Thorns?" Philip put a hand on her back, trying to push her along. How her dress had changed. "I want porridge," she said, unmoving. "Porridge? Look, I know you're hungry. I am too, famished. But we can't linger in the village anymore. We can't trust anyone. You've seen that. We'll grab something along the way. Nuts, a grouse, maybe. Just walking around about one earlier made me hungry." Aurora Rose shook her head and set her jaw. "In the last few months at the castle, or minutes, or whatever they are in the real world, I started to see things. Things I wanted to see. Pictures of the way the world was before. Well, before the fake apocalypse was supposed to have happened. I saw a vision of a bunny." "A bunny?" "Yes, a bunny. I wanted more than anything to see and touch a real rabbit. And one appeared, and then the fairies appeared, and then when I was escaping, I sort of wished that the thorns that had held me would go, let me go, and they did." Philip looked at her, still confused. "They did? Could you please stop just repeating the last thing that I said and actually listen to me? It's my dream. My touching the spindle caused all of this. I'm the first one who fell asleep under her spell. It's why Maleficent had to lie and make up the sort of reason for all of us to be trapped together. She doesn't have complete control of this world, or whatever it is. It's part of me. You said so yourself." "All right, that makes sense," Philip said in a serious voice, arms folded and face frowning. "But what does that have to do with porridge?" "I want porridge," she said, exasperated. "That's all. I wanted a bunny before it, and it appeared. And now I want porridge. The way my aunts used to make it on cold mornings, warm and buttery, with rich toast acorns in it." "Acorns? Really? That sounds, it's an interesting gastronomic choice." She rolled her eyes. "We live in the middle of a forest, Royal Prince. It was what we had, and a real treat in the middle of winter." Then she proceeded to ignore him. She closed her eyes and cupped her hands. She prayed and wished and imagined and begged. Philip stayed politely silent, though he did look around, sigh a little, and do all sorts of other things to obviously fret over the passage of time. She tried to call up the feel of the wooden bowl in her hands. It warmed almost like flesh, where the wood was thin and the heat of her fingers and the hot porridge mingled. She summoned the smell, a mix of dairy and things of the earth, and the tall green grass in the woods. Sometimes there was even a dollop of honey on top. She thought so hard she felt like she had to go to the privy. Her concentration faltered for the moment when she distractedly wondered if that ever had happened to Maleficent when she was performing an incantation. But after a few seconds, she was back in her dream of porridge. Time passed. Good Lord. The smell in her head was giving way to a real scent in her nose now, with even that faint, almost untasty burnt smell the acorns sometimes give off. She smiled and opened her eyes. In her hands was a cracked wooden bowl full of porridge, just like she remembered. "Can you get me some eggs and a drumstick?" Philip said eagerly. "Maybe a tankard of beer to go with it." Eat the porridge, greedy bird, she said, smiling. Oh, all right, he said with a sigh. It is certainly a lot better than nothing. Well done and all. Shall we use our hands? She tried to summon two spoons. But which ones? The big wooden paddle Merriweather stirred their soup with, or tiny teaspoons for fancy afternoons? Or each one flitted up in her mind and then disappeared. She shrugged apologetically. I can't concentrate. Too hungry. Well, this won't be the first time, Philip said, wiping his hands carefully on his cape. Let's dig in. They did, giggling. As she licked the first scoop of, and the warm, familiar cereal filled her mouth, she, filled with a warmth and happiness that she hadn't known in a long time.
There you go. So if you want porridge, just imagine it.
Apparently, that's all you got to do.
That's all you got
to
do.
That's the story where we're at right now. So she awoke from stage two into stage three, and that's where we're at now.
That's where we're at.
Okay.
But we're back in stage two.
But now we're back in stage two.
Yeah.
Where the guy had the bird song with her.
Right. Yeah. Weeny bay, howdy, howdy, howdy.
Hola.
So is the privy. So the privy, I thought it was a bathroom, but I guess.
I don't know. The whole sword conversation.
His porridge like shrimp and grits. I don't think it has the Cajun sauce with it, though. So. Leaves us there. Yes. Well, there's an interlude. And then
you can do the interlude if you want. Three pages.
Yeah, we'll do the interlude.
Go ahead.
All right. So here's the interlude. I never realized just how infinitely boring the prattle of human teenagers was, Maleficent drawled. But her voice was even thicker than irony required. She seemed slow, like a mechanical bird winding down. Interesting. Mechanical bird.
Yeah.
I hope we don't have to put up with much more of their fascinating discussion of philosophy and the nature of reality, or the culinary delights of porridge. I thought the part of the porridge was fairly interesting, Leona spoke up, perhaps emboldened by her mistress's weakness, especially the part where she summoned it out of the air. Maleficent's yellow eyes flickered toward her. Yes, that was interesting. And troubling. Who knew the girl had it in her? You didn't, Leona pointed out tonelessly. There is much more to her than you originally thought, considering how she has evaded all of your traps, even the particularly clever nightmare inside the nightmare. It will be harder to kill her now that she is beginning to unlock the power of her own dream world. I don't need to kill her, Maleficent said with a satisfied smile. All I need to do is delay her. She has 1 hour and 2 minutes to figure out how to defeat me and wake up. If she is in my power when the clock strikes 12 and the next day begins, I win. But you're right, Maleficent said thoughtfully, swirling the green and red liquids in the orb of her staff. It might be time to step up the direct assaults on her personage. I need the work of my cleverest, strongest servants. Aragol Slunder Agrabrux to me. Long, slow-moving, grinning black forms congealed from the shadows in the corners of the room, and Liana's opaque eyes might have shown a hint of concern.
Glad we read that.
So she is still watching them.
And Maleficent is ramping up the army
with
Agrabrex.
And apparently there's a countdown.
Yeah.
Yeah. And we're, 57% of the way through the book?
A couple of the other books I've read don't make it all the way to 100. Okay. Because they let you read the next chapters or whatever, and that counts as part of your 100% because it's in there. So we'll see. I like that because you don't know when it's going to end.
That's true. So it shows.
I hope the next one's a little better than this one.
I do too. This shows page 251 of 432 or something, but still that could be with that first.
Wow.
Yeah. Sneak peek at the next book or whatever they do. So there you go.
Yep.
That's our book club for tonight. This is where we'd normally turn and start doing a puzzle and Lego and different stuff like that. Steve can turn and I can turn that other camera on.
That's what we're building.
That's what we're building. So. So, yeah. Steve's the first YouTube person to see the house in the area where I grew up.
Pretended to be your friend for 4 years to get to this point. No, I'm just kidding. Turn the camera a little bit more. I don't need to be on camera.
So, yeah. Before Steve got here, came in, met the parents, hung out a little while. We came down here. I showed him around the studio and whatnot. And then I decided to take him around town and show him around. We just need to put a nipple on that, I think. Not that one.
Oh.
Not that. It's not. No. We don't need that in. Yeah. Dang, that means I still have a ways before I get to, yeah. And yeah, took him around, showed him town, and
we did.
Took him to the house I grew up in, and yeah,
church, and we went to the grocery store.
Yeah, he went to my grocery. I think he was shocked at how big our grocery store was.
It was big.
It was a big store.
It's bigger than any house around it. Well, I mean, of course, it's proportionally bigger than the town. And they're getting bigger.
Yeah. Stevie K says, Chris, blink twice if you need help. No, I'm good.
That was my drink.
sunflower seeds. There you go. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Debbie says, I was confused in the beginning and now I'm confused. All confused again. Yeah, this book likes to do that. Just when you start, you start to think you're grasping. What's the name of the grocery store? It's called Ingles. Ingles. Ingles.
I wouldn't have said that.
Yeah. So. Yeah.
So.
Steve is killing. Nicole's enjoying your performance.
Ow.
So, yeah, that.
You all right?
Oh, God. Y'all couldn't hear that a bit. Oh, Wendy B says they have a few Ingles down there. Yeah, this is my earbud.
Oh, okay.
So this is my, Steve was, this is my. On my desk. Yeah. It's my earbuds case. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So DNT, so will DNT be happened from the Dead Bills? No.
Will not be. No. Although my room is bigger this time.
Oh, nice.
They said, you were here last week. I said, I was, and I'll be here the next couple weeks. I said, we're going to take care of you. We're putting you in a better room.
Oh, sweet.
I have the same room, except around the corner. I have a big couch, a big L-shaped couch, and there's no TV. You just look at the window or the wall. From the window.
To the wall.
To the sweat. What?
It is a pants on stream.
He made me wear pants. He didn't like it. I was sitting here all comfy. He said, you got to put pants on if you're going to sit in my seat.
That's, yeah. So. Yep. Plus, when we got up to change seats, it's a good thing we have pants on.
So, why?
Well, they would have got an awful.
Is it like that awkward? That's being generous. Is it like an that awkward? Is it like that awkward? Moment in the men's locker room when two people go down at the same time, their butts touch. It's like, is that, I mean, it was on Raymond. I saw it on Everybody Loves Raymond.
That's true.
We shall never speak of this.
Tanya today went to over to Fort Wilderness and went and saw the horses. And there was a horse literally up against the stable railing with its butt pressed all the way up, pointing straight at you. She kept trying to get the horse to turn around and take a better angle, but no. Yeah. One-way fence. Yeah. That's true. That's true. So. Yep. This is fun.
There's puzzles everywhere.
There are puzzles everywhere.
What's this one for? Just look at that picture?
No, so when I build, I move the screen over there. There's a third monitor over here. I guess.
That's the best one, too.
Yeah, it's the biggest.
It's got the castle on it.
It does. So a lot of times what I'll do is if we're streaming and there's a game or a race on, that's the screen that I put the game on.
Yeah, because you're always looking off like this direction.
Yeah.
I always wondered who was over here.
Yep. That's it.
Look, we got the blue lights. We got the red lights.
Oh, we fixed the water tower. Steve helped plug that in.
What happened to the TV?
Oh, the TV changed.
But I still see fish.
Is it still the fish?
Well, there's fish, and what have you been watching?
The Northern Flicker.
The Northern Flicker. That sounds appropriate.
The Northern, you know, the Northern Flicker. Bird. Chris, do you have a what?
You have a gate?
No. Not a door nor a gate.
That's a big microphone.
It is.
Well done, sir.
Thank you. I believe in. So here's the other fun thing. Me and you do this sometimes. Here is my soundboard.
Oh.
So if you come in here.
That's exactly what mine looks like.
Yeah, and then here's all the effects that I have. Oh, yeah. Wait. Here. All the.
Ooh. Where'd you know that from?
These are all World of Warcraft because it's.
I just noticed the base.
Yeah. And then the back. So that's why I can do all the different world, but we can't hear them here.
It's a hippo.
That's a hippo. So these are the hippo stickers that Joy sent me. Aww. When I was recovering.
Very nice.
And Joy should be, I guess, in the air about now. So Joy, hope you have a safe flight. Yeah.
You didn't miss me, Happy Song. I'm right here.
Right here. They call it the I-4 flicker.
You know.
Yeah. Kate Ula Lane, hello. Good to see you. Just in case you're wondering, when women visit friends, we generally wear pants too. Well, that's good.
Well, you should. It's different than men. What?
Nothing.
You got some cool toys around here that you don't ever show anybody.
Yeah.
Like. That changed colors when I touched it.
It changes colors. That's my charging cable.
Oh, it goes from green to pink to now it's red.
Yeah.
Oh.
Purple.
I thought I did it when I touched it.
No, it glows. Yeah. That's a chip bag holder. We sold those on the round table one night.
Oh. Yeah. Grip sticks.
Grip sticks. Yep.
I'm just touching things now.
You are. This is my Grogu cup.
I see that.
The whole stuff. It's kind of creepy looking, and I don't know why I put it there, but I do.
So, Steve, what is that? Why do you have it?
That's the Taylor Swift cup I got when I went to the movies with Snickerdoodle. I knew you'd be happy to see that, so I sent it out for you.
Should have poured chocolate milk in it and then just thrown it across the room.
We went to the movies and saw Argyle.
Yes.
Yeah. And then we both got a drink, and they gave them to us in that cup. Yeah, there's my... Steve's touching my lightsaber. That's not a phrase you normally hear. Yep.
I'm God.
I like that one.
Whose is it?
That's the Cal Kestis.
Oh. That little piece there is a little annoying. But outside of that, that's cool.
They've come out with a new one that has the perfected end
on it. What size is this blade? 32?
That's the, yeah.
They go up to 36, don't they?
That's the 36
then. Oh, it is the 36. Okay. Yeah.
You have tape measure? I have the longest blade they have.
You have a tape measure? I want to
see. I don't have a tape measure right now. I had to take it back into the house. Yeah, measuring
about,
things.
It's about 36 inches.
That's about 36. Feels about right.
Yeah. Good weight on the shaft here. That's
Stacy Rogers. Freak. What?
Oh, Chris, I need this to do this.
Yeah, you do.
Hi! I get my red one because I have like all the different colors, and the red one will look like ET's finger. And I can sit way back here and do it when you're saying the lows to everybody. Just like,
that's
okay. Oh, that came on by itself.
Oh, so many inches, says Molly.
That's twice the size Molly likes. She likes the 18-inch blade.
That's true. The 18-inch water tower?
Is that how it was? Nope.
Nope.
Here, I'll let you put it away. Oh, like that. Yeah. Well, it was kind of shoved in there. Do you want it wedged back in there?
No, not really.
I'm afraid it's going to fall. Let's do this. Let's just turn it slightly, like that. Okay. Now it's not going to fall.
Yeah, but now it's on that slippy part. It's okay.
As long as it doesn't fall while I'm here, then it's your problem.
Yeah. It's like Chris has a junior higher in his office.
Is that in here?
No. He was playing his video game.
What other snacks did I get?
Triple A Sparkles. You got Buttermints. Yes.
I did get Buttermints.
Hey, good to see you, Sparks.
I know. Chris doesn't even have a tape measure in here. I got like six.
I know. I had one and I took it back into the house to measure something. I forgot to bring it back. I've got sugar-free pudding if you want
a pudding cup. Nope, nope. No, I just wonder what I got. I saw the bag over there.
I got cheese sticks.
I bought... there's some surprise over there. I don't know what it was. I got one thing that was just like not healthy for me.
What other toys does Dad Builds have that Steve can play with?
You guys have no idea. Like, I can make this desk go up and down.
Yeah, the build desk goes up and down.
He's got...
Now, there's puzzles little everywhere.
Uh-oh, I'm sitting on the paper.
Oh, it's okay. Here we go.
I mean, there's a drawer here. I don't even know what's in it yet. I haven't even looked.
Junk. It's also mint.
Well, see, that's what I told you not to put that there.
That's why I told you.
I mean,
all the trivia questions are in there too.
We've even got Steve. Pink Steve.
Pink Steve. No, they do not, Nicole.
What? Well,
Nick wants to know if you've seen the spider yet. There is no spider. The spider's dead.
The spider wasn't in this room.
That's true. He saw the original studio.
He did. And there's a spider in there.
But yeah. Yep.
So. You wouldn't see the spider in here. No. It would. Chris would just find it crawling up his leg. You'd feel it.
Steve's like the little brother getting into all your stuff and messing it up.
His toys are my toys.
Yeah. So.
I'd like to thank my mom and dad for getting together one night and creating me. I'd like to thank Dad Builds for this amazing opportunity. And I thank all you, all the little people out there that,
and nothing. Steve walked in and saw that. He's like, oh, you got one of those. I was like, yeah, you sent it to me.
I forgot.
Is Steve going to work with a Southern twang next week? Well, maybe.
Hi, y'all.
It's like Steve's all jacked up on Mountain Dew shots.
I haven't even had anything.
You haven't? No.
Chick-fil-A.
I offered him some ham when he came. We had ham tonight.
Yeah, they had ham. I got some midnight chocolate, promised land, whole milk.
How did you like it? You weren't sure.
All right. He's not.
A Trumu fan, which
I'm a Trumu fan.
I put Trumu here and promised land here. Promised land's more creamy and rich.
See, thicker. Trumu for me is Trumu stains the sides of my glasses. I have to go in and wash them real good. I mean, I got to wash them anyways, but. I've not been drinking anything.
No.
I haven't even opened my zero sugar. Well, these have no caffeine anyways, but zero sugar A&W root beer. Look at that. Calories zero. Total fat zero. Total carbs zero. Added sugar zero. Oh,
you know what I could make you?
Would you make me?
Yeah, I can make you some. I could make you some of my tuna mix. With light mayonnaise.
Nope. Double nope.
Yeah.
Or I will vomit all over all of this, and then I will leave. What's that bowl for?
This bowl?
Yeah.
That's my wax melt.
Oh. Yeah. Some weird wax you got in there.
Yeah, it's Lego extra pieces. I when I was putting together Lego, the other night.
Yep. That board's cool. I want to push these buttons. Can I push this one?
Yeah, they won't hear it. But
oh, they won't? How about that one? Don't hit which one?
Here, let's do this. So if we push the buttons. You can push the buttons.
My circle's in Indiana or in Florida.
Now we go here. Now you can push like these buttons or those buttons and they'll hear it.
That tastes like goat butt.
That tastes like goat butt.
That's what Jeff said.
What does this say?
I wish I would have brought some underwear.
They're all Jeff. Okay, here we go.
I gave you all I had to give. Anybody need a vibrator?
Jeff said that too. Yeah, I can load some more in there.
Wait a minute, what? All those?
Yeah.
What do these do?
Well, this one does this.
La 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 la. La 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 la. Oh, you touch the hammer. Turn around, it's better than yours. Turn around, it's better than yours. That's got my name on it.
Need my pickle to yodel again?
Why is little lady who? I don't know what that one is. This is the ant.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh yeah, baby.
Oh yeah, baby. This is the way.
We know her.
Oh. How many can you load in there?
Well, there's like 10 pages.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
I need this.
There's.
That's the thing you had to play backwards.
Where we played it backwards. Yeah. So. But you come in here and you like drag this over. And then we go here to the clips. And then we find we can do that one.
Oh, it already showed up there.
Yep.
And if I hit it now, will it mess you up?
Nope.
Angela's taking my clothes off.
Yep. What? What kind of stream is this?
There you go. There's another new one.
Angela is.
Angela's gonna be so mad.
That's the story of his life. Story of his life.
Yep.
This is a really cool lighting you have up here.
You like that?
I do. I'm trying to figure out what the pulley system is right here. What's this? Or is that just a connector?
That's just a connector.
Yeah. Never mind.
There's another new one for you.
Oh, what's this? That's got my name on it.
Yeah, it does.
Oh, he's not here anymore. He's gone. Steve has sailed off into the sunset. Steve is gone. Steve is no longer with us.
I remember that one. And he was so happy about it, too.
Very happy.
No. Steve's gone.
Do you have the video clips, too? Or is that what these do, too? Do they push?
No.
Oh.
I have to load them into.
I kind of want to see the Vespa one again, but that's okay. We can watch that
later. I've got that.
Oh, you do?
I can drop it. What is that?
Oh, it's a spider.
It's not a spider.
Oh, it's got wings. It's a spider with wings. I got a lightsaber. I can take it out. But I'm going to be swinging hard.
Let's see. Where is. Not that one. There's with Steve.
I thought it said pickle music. Puzzle music.
Puzzle. Yeah. That's the ones from the Halloween stream. This is, here you go.
That's it.
That's the one.
Now, do I get to push a button or do you have to do
it
over there?
You have to press it here.
Oh, but what's that?
It doesn't work there.
That's like those old AT&T dial-up things where you just go,
yeah.
Like you're connecting to the dial-up?
That's how it shows when it loads.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. There's these.
Oh, wait a minute. Let's see here. That one. We got to play that one. Yeah.
And then
this is for all you out there watching. You're going to be very happy.
We'll do that one first.
Yeah.
Okay. Here we go.
Okay. Oh, it's so good.
And then I don't know if she's still here or not. But here you go.
Yeah, you get in the front.
What's the friend's name, guys?
Come on, Rob. Get on.
Come on, Rob.
Hold on, Rob. You gotta hold on. You gotta fall off.
It's all right, Rob.
I'll sit like you get on first.
It's
Alberto.
I can't believe he's gonna jump up. Oh my god. That was way too much steam I could handle. Holy cow. Woo!
Alright, let's go. Keep moving.
I can't breathe.
Come on.
I can't breathe.
Come on.
Oh, Rob's face. Rob's face, and he's like, that's more steam than I can handle.
Gifted, what can I say?
That was, yeah.
I know how to ride a Vespa.
That was way too much, Steve. There's more of those.
Yeah.
There's these.
Hmm. What's that last one?
This one?
Yeah. Oh, I like the other one too. That one.
This one?
Yeah.
We'll just play all of them since she's not here.
Let's do it. I'm a sucker for you. Said a word and I'll go anywhere blindly. I'm a sucker for you. Yep.
And then
this one's I like this one. Finger guns.
Oh wait, she's back.
Oh, Shatina's here.
Tina's here. Hey, Tina.
Ooh, Tina. Yeah.
Yep.
More puzzles? What is this?
It's the.
I saw a new one today.
Yeah.
I think I took a picture of it. Let me look.
Play Vespa again.
Why?
I don't know.
Who said play Vespa again?
Mar. They said it was echoing. I forgot I was sharing the screen. Where's the naked bath? I don't have the naked bathroom man. That one was a flipper creation. So I don't have that one.
What was that looking at? Oh yeah, pictures of puzzles.
We do have this one.
Why?
We could do I was just looking at it. Where did
he's an angry elf.
He's an angry elf.
This is what happens. I start watching TikTok and I take pictures of all the stuff that I wanted to go back and look at.
Oh, yeah. This is one of my favorite mixtures. So this is a two-part clip.
Okay.
Here's part one.
Part one.
Waiting for it to load.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wait. I like what I named that one too.
Apparently, I didn't take a picture of the puzzle.
But Wendy B, this is $1 for every time Nicole has bit her tongue in chat. He swore he was muted. He did. Thank you, Wendy. This one's very appropriate tonight.
You all gallivant with your fancy foosball friends at school while I'm sitting here all day with nobody to keep me company except Steve?
So here's something interesting about my glue. Like, I have different bottles for the front and the back of my puzzles.
I'm glueless tonight. I feel naked.
Yeah.
I don't know what to do.
I'm going to go back to.
Do you have any glue I can just hold? Like, just hold it so it feels better?
Not really. I mean, it's over there in the box.
I'm not getting up.
Let me see. Where is.
I told you my favorite dad joke now, right?
Yeah. What are you doing, Wendy B?
What?
It's showing Wendy you did it twice. This is $1 for every time Gitchy is bit her tongue tonight. Wendy, stop that. Thank you. We need the dude to do. I'm looking for that.
That's
one.
That's what he's trying to play. Yeah. I told him he used to play that one.
Tina said, keep picking on Steve. Night, night for real this time. Well, night, Tina. Now that you're going to be able to play some more, Tina. Oh,
That spider's back. Flying around here.
That's not a spider. Not a duma.
With eight legs.
Where did that... I can't find that clip.
It's gone. Is it already added?
No, because I had to delete it for the movie thing the other night. But I still had it on the computer somewhere.
I got a great idea for a new game, a new stream, or a new vlog.
Oh, yeah?
Should I tell people or should I hold it in?
I'll tell them.
I'm going to create a live version of Hungry Hungry Hippos.
Oh.
Where four of us have to lay down and there's this pan in the middle. We can only use our necks to go try to grab as many marshmallows as we can. It's hungry, hungry. And that's a real thing. I'm really doing it.
That would be interesting.
But we're going to have partners that have our feet. And they're going to be able to wheel us in and pull us out and wheel us in and pull us out.
What? Why can't I find?
It's an optical illusion, Diana. It's, with the power of technology, we can cast one person to the other person's stream.
Yep. Oh, let's
see. If I try to touch Chris, it just goes right through him. What are those on there for?
This is all.
Holy crap. What are you doing with all my.
All the stuff that I've used on you?
You have a whole album of me.
I do.
I'm flattered.
I'm trying to find. There's all those. All the audio clips of you.
Well, it's going to be an audio clip. It's not going to be anything else, is it?
No, it's a video.
Is it?
Yeah.
What pops up? Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. I can't find it. I don't know where it went. I may have to have that person send it to me again. That's disappointing. Horson shouldn't. You can read that one.
I think there's a typo in there. Or is there?
I'm not sure that there is, Steve.
I mean, you like Domino, or what do you like?
Golly, I can't find that. That's disappointing. I gotta get that back. Thought it was somewhere there, but it's not there. That's gonna take some hunting. Yep. She doesn't mean that, Sugar Steve.
I mean, do you want Walmart brand? What are we talking
about? I'm thinking maybe like Splenda or maybe that kind of sugar, fake sugar.
I don't know.
Sweet and low.
Got it.
That's what she's forcing to sweeten.
Hopefully she doesn't want a lot of me ripping open a lot of packages. Like, or what if I pour them all into a bowl first and I just dump the bowl on it? That'll work out better.
You can buy like the big bags at Sam's and Costco.
Yeah. 5-pound bag.
Donna Murphy, hello.
She's so tiny, though. A 5-pound bag would be like burying her in the sand.
Yeah, that's true. It wouldn't take much. She says she wants the real sugar.
Sugar cane?
I guess so.
That hurt. You're whipping somebody with a bamboo stick.
Maybe some of that agave syrup.
Oh, agave.
Agave.
Got it. It'd be like Grogu.
You're going to spill that all over the
song. Oh, wow.
This is... Good night, Jennifer Crusoe.
This was supposed to be for me to drink for breakfast every morning.
Yeah, it's gone.
It's almost gone. What happened, Chris? You're a bad influence.
Yep. Doing good, Dinah Murphy. Thank you. Stop playing around, Steve. OMG, says Molly. Well, I guess we need to.
Oh, it's 11 o'clock.
It's 11 o'clock.
Yeah.
Somebody's got to drive again.
Yeah.
So we could sit here for another couple hours, I think.
But, easily. You know. Easily.
Stacy drove here. He flew to Charlotte, but he drove here.
Oh yeah, both.
Planes, trains, and automobiles. Just no trains.
Well, we went over some train tracks.
Oh, that's true. We did go over train tracks.
And on my way here, I saw a train up on the overpass.
Yeah. Those aren't pillows.
What are pillows?
I hope everybody has a good night. Yeah, I did.
Oh, okay.
Hope everybody has a good night and a good, tomorrow's Wednesday. We've made it halfway through the week, Steve. I hope everybody has a good night. Tina will be live tomorrow at 5, and this guy will be on with This and That tomorrow night at 9 o'clock.
Oh, we got real stuff doing tomorrow, too.
Do you?
I better figure it out.
What are we doing? What are you doing?
Okay. I'm going to throw a thumbnail up later, so.
Okay.
Listen, there's a full moon, or no, there's not. There's a total eclipse of the heart on Monday, and there's going to be some Nostradamus-like predictions on Wednesday.
That's amazing. That'll be
That's
fun.
All I'm going to say.
That'll be fun. So, check that out, and I'll see you in the streams, and I think Pete goes live after y'all and at some time, and I'm just here to have fun, and we might be back Thursday night after Jeff and Corey, and I don't know. Love y'all. Thank you for hanging out.
Hey, real quick.
Uh-huh.
What's the weather like up here? Because it's really bad compared to Florida.
It fluctuates.
Yeah, so it was 91 degrees today.
Yeah.
It's going to be 39 on Thursday.
That's true.
Why?
Well, we feel here that if it stays the same all the time, you'll get bored. So we change it up.
Oh. The minute I thought God hated you guys.
That could be the answer too, but you can get sticky around here. Not so sweet, but real sticky too.
That's because of the agave syrup.
That's true. The agave. It's all over. Have a good night, everybody.
There's more to talk about.
Yeah, but you.
Okay, I won't make you keep going.
Love you all. You get to sit here right in the sling zone this time. That look.
You teach me real quick. How does this happen?
You go like this.
No, it's so weird. The fingers, your fingers just bouncing up like this.
Yeah, like kind of like that.
You're my puppets.
Love y'all. We'll see. See you next. Oh, I got to click the button. See y'all next time.
Toodles.
Bye, toodles.